Hey guys, it's Danielle. Welcome back to my channel. Today's video is going to be another Goodwill thrifting video, and then I also inserted some clips from a different thrift store at the end just because I didn't end up purchasing anything that day, so I thought I would just include it. And then of course I'll share my haul with you at the end of the video. I thought this bunny on the egg was really cute. I did notice at the time that his ear was chipped, but it was very mid-century looking to me, so I just thought it was adorable. And then this is a piece that I've looked at multiple times, and I'm wondering if I should purchase it when it's on sale, if it's still there, of course, and possibly try to put it on eBay. It just seems like a piece that someone might like with the like bluebirds, and it just looks vintage to me, although it might not be. And then I really loved this metal pitcher as well. I'm not sure if it's pewter or what, but I just thought it was really nice. I probably should have purchased it. I wish this item had been in a cool green color or even a more neutral color, and I would have purchased it, but the bright blue just isn't my thing. I'm hoping to find a clock like this while out thrifting or yard selling or anywhere affordable. That's the same size but in a really dark wood and maybe with some like pretty details or something, and definitely vintage. This one didn't have a price on it and I wasn't a fan of the stain of the wood, like that unfinished wood. I didn't like it. I've recently been seeing a lot of really good artwork at my surrounding Goodwills. For instance, this one here, well, not the artwork, the frame was incredible. They had it priced at $29.99. I wasn't really interested in the middle artwork piece, but I did think the frame was beautiful. But the rest of this is all, or they were all at one Goodwill in one day, which is very rare for me to find that many pieces at one store. Thank you. we've moved on to the second thrift store that I stopped into. I don't go here often because it's a bit of a ways away, and you can find good stuff here for good prices, but if it is vintage or they know it's an antique, they will price it sometimes higher than actual antique stores. So this day I didn't find anything. I did think this shelf was really cute. I don't even think I filmed the price tag properly because there was someone just standing there watching me film, and it was making me really nervous. I do have a bit of a weak spot for silver trays, especially when they're large like this, and I love this one, but there was no way I was going to pay $20 for it. I really liked this little swan piece. At the time, I couldn't find out how much it was, but I ended up seeing that it was, I think, $4.99, and I didn't feel like $5 was worth that. Sometimes people price milk glass much higher than it's worth, in my opinion. I thought this would be really pretty in the summertime with a plant inside of it, but once again, just not going to pay $20 at a thrift store. Alright, I'm going to go ahead and show you the things that I purchased. I did get this really beautiful oil painting. It is super large. I'm not even sure. I want to say like 24 inches. It was $9.99, which normally I wouldn't want to pay $10 at a thrift store, but it's really large, like I said, and I've paid that for a much smaller oil painting that I loved. And I don't know what I'm going to do with this yet. I'm thinking, obviously, like closer to when we're in the middle of summer, I can mix in some blues and possibly my kitchen on those shelves. Lincoln is barking in the background if that's picking up. Anyways, I actually put a poll on my Instagram asking, you know, yes or no, and everyone said yes for the most part. So, I also blame you guys for peer pressure. This has like a black velvet outline, which I don't really use black much, so we'll see if I can make that work. This is more of like a gold tone too, but you know what? It's fine. Maybe I could strip off the gold and get it down to the wood, but I just really love it. I think it's super beautiful. Here's a close-up shot if you don't remember it from the clips. It is signed. I think it says Mary. Okay, and then I got this cute little wooden pot. I don't know what this is. I mean, it's obviously a pot, and it's hinged. It's off the hinges, but it's hinged. But I thought it was cute, and it would be cute in the kitchen. I'm thinking about drilling a hole in it so I can hang it from my little like metal rods and hooks that I have in there. And then I purchased the Homer Laughlin restaurant wear pieces. I think it's restaurant wear. They were 79 cents a piece, so I did get all four of them. I have the other two styled in my kitchen. And I got them thinking I was going to resell them, but I love them so much. It's almost like a jade green color with a little more teal in it. And I just think they're really good, like heavy, good quality cups. So I really loved those. And I think I'm gonna keep them. I got two pillowcases simply for the fabric. I do have a collection of vintage floral pillowcases, and I haven't picked any up in a while. I thought this one was so pretty. The colors are so interesting. Not something that I've seen before. I think they were $1.99 a piece, if I'm correct. But isn't this pattern just so pretty? I don't know what I'm gonna do with this yet. I'm not the best at sewing, I've learned, so. And then I got this one, which is more like feminine and shabby chic. It looks like a, like Rachel Ashwell or Laura Ashley print, but just a really pretty, dainty pillowcase. All these beautiful roses, and it has some blue bows on here somewhere. So yeah, I got both of those, and I'll have to figure out what I'm going to turn them into, or I'll just display them. I think it's Jamie from Border Bananas. She has some of them displayed in a basket, like rolled up, and you can see all the beautiful fabrics, and I think that's so pretty. But yeah, that is everything that I purchased in this video. I hope you guys enjoyed watching. Give this video a thumbs up if you did enjoy it, and subscribe for more content, and I will talk to you in my next video. Bye!